Father, we love you. We thank you. We praise your name, Jesus. We thank you for tonight. This is a night that we were not promised. This is a night that you allowed us to be here, to come and celebrate and to remember Donnie Wilson, his life, the life that you gave him, Lord. And we're just honored to be here and to be a part of this. And we just ask you just to have your way in this service, that your spirit would take over, that you would help us to remember Donnie Wilson, and he was your child. You created him, Lord. And we thank you for all the things that you did in his life. But mainly, Lord, for salvation, Lord, for you coming into his heart and taking over his life. So, God, we have so many things to thank him for, and we'll do that. And we'll remember Brother Donnie. So just help us tonight. Help the family. Help our friends. Help our church family, Lord, to soak all this up and just to remember Donnie for who he was. He was so much to so many different people. So God, I thank you for tonight. And just help us and be with us, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right, you may be seated. And we're going to have a slideshow here in a second. We may get a light or two. Yeah, get that light.
I can't believe that I'm here, having to say goodbye, and I can barely see you through these tears I cry. I close my eyes, I can't hear the sound as angels gather. Saying this is where you belong. Welcome home. There are the days that my heart aches, wishing you were here. But I know where you are, the hurt and the pain disappear. There's no more tears. I can hear the sound as angels thank you.
All right. I've asked my Aunt Shelley to come up, and she's going to say a few words, and she's going to actually read a post from my brother Aaron, who couldn't make it tonight, that expressed his feelings for Donnie. So she's going to read it for him, and she's got a few things she wants to say herself.
God bless. Thank you, everybody, for coming. It's nice to be in the house of the Lord to celebrate somebody's life. Amen. Knowing that He is at home with our Father and at peace. This is from my nephew, Aaron, who just really summed it up. And pardon these old eyes while I scroll. Sometimes you just know that you have been blessed knowing someone because of the impact they leave on you and your loved ones. For me, Donnie Wilson was that man. He came to my siblings and I by surprise, but the timing was not an accident. How many of you know God doesn't do accidents? Amen. He loved my mother with his entire heart and accepted her children as his own. In the 4+ years I had the chance to see and know him, he gave me a man that someone could emulate. On November 24th, around 2:30 p.m., Donnie and I were talking, and he said he was tired and decided to go take a nap before Alina could come home from work. Little did he know that our Lord had other plans. It's not our timing, is it? It's all about God. Instead of greeting my mother and having dinner with her this evening, he left this world and is in heaven eating dinner with God. Renee found him with his feet crossed and the blankets over him. That tells us there was no struggle and that Donnie passed without pain or suffering, which we all know is the best and easiest way to go. God is good, isn't he? Yes, we will miss his physical presence here with us, but we will also celebrate the choices that he made so that he can live eternally, pain-free. I smile to think that when he met God this afternoon, one of the first questions he probably asked was, where's the best fishing spot? Donnie liked driving, so I'm sure the streets of gold are something to see. But I have a gut feeling that he went as fast as he could and dropped a few lines in the water already. I grieve for my mother as the man who finally showed her true worth and that she would be treated and loved like a queen left today, but I also know she is stronger because of him. Please keep her, Anthony, and our family in your prayers and hold your loved ones close because none of us are guaranteed tomorrow. Amen. So true. I have a scripture that I'm going to read. This is one of my favorite scriptures. It's Proverbs 3:5. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not into thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him who shall direct thy paths. I chose that scripture because it's not our understanding. Nobody knows the day or the hour that God will choose to take you from here. But how beautiful that we can celebrate a life that knew Jesus and that you got 5 years of wonderful with him. I knew Donnie when he was younger, and I knew Alina and Donnie when they were younger, and I knew the love that they had for each other then. Now God may have had another plan for you to leave each other for a while, but then you came back. And God gave you so much with each other. Not only Anthony, but he gave Donnie, not just you, he gave Donnie his last years of happiness on this earth with you. And we can all celebrate tonight because Donnie knew the Lord. I grew up knowing Donnie. We went to the same church house. And Donnie was a God-fearing man from a young person. He loved the Lord. His whole family celebrated the Lord. He knew the Lord as his own personal Savior and Redeemer from a young person. So I don't believe it's an accident, Alina, when he brought the two of you back together to celebrate your lives together and to let him have one little bit of wonderful before he left and had a whole eternity of wonderful. Thank you, and I'm so glad to see you all here celebrating with my family and celebrating Donnie's life. And yes, we'll mourn him on this earth. We will mourn him because he was a beautiful person. He was a strong person. But we all know that was just an earth suit. We know that his soul went to be with the Lord as soon as he left. Amen. Thank you all.
Brought some notes in case I get choked up and I lose my place.
That's all right. Take your time.
But God will help me.
Yes, he will.
I won't have to look at those things. So a lot of my church family know that it's not easy to get up here to talk in front of a crowd. But I'm going to do it anyway because God's going to help me. And I want to do my best to remember my dad. So I'm going to say a few things and then we're going to sing a few songs. But just bear with me for a second. I think Shelley said it best. We don't know God's ways. We don't understand God's ways, but we know his ways are better than our ways. And little did I know, a little over 4 years ago, that my life was going to change again. But that's how God works. And for me, it started right here at this very church when Dr. Jones was preaching a sermon that touched my mom's heart. And then from there, the rest is history. After that service, I found out about Donnie. Talked to Donnie, saw pictures of Donnie, and I couldn't refute it. I couldn't deny it. It was just, it was too much similarities there. A little bit later, I think a couple months, weeks, I can't remember how long it was, I went to Illinois and I met him for the first time, and I had a couple pictures up here with him. First time I ever met my dad, so God is good.
Yes, he is.
And again, we don't know the path that he's going to take us on, but he'll get us where we need to be. So I thank him for that. If you knew Donnie, some of you knew him from church, from Sundays, and then you guys knew him for a while. He was easy to connect with, and he was easy to talk to. He was laid back. You almost never saw him with a frown on his face, at least I didn't. Never had a mean thing to say about most people. But he was so peaceful and loving, and I look down here, and I know he connected with so many of you guys. I think of Will and Renee. If you didn't know it by their relationship, you'd think they would know each other their whole lives instead of the 4+ years. I mean, they got along like family that knew each other the whole lives. So I thank you, Renee. I thank Will for taking him in and loving on him the way that y'all did. I appreciate that, and I know he loves you guys with all his heart. And I think about Will. I don't see him in here. Just the way he connected with Will, they were either outside smoking a cigarette or they were smoking a brisket. But that was their thing. That's how they connected. So that was their thing. And with Renee, you know, Ray was everything to Donnie. He loved that little baby. She's back there now. You saw pictures of them together. So he connected that way. With Roman and Lanisa, this is their grandpa.
Yeah.
They have a grandpa on my mom's side, or their mom's side, but this is grandpa on this side. And he loved on them too, the best he could, in the little bit of time that they had. So I'm grateful they had that time with him.
Amen.
Really blessed for him to be in their lives. Especially him coming to church and setting that example for them. It meant the world to me. I talked to his twin brother. You guys may not know. He has a twin brother. I called him today and just asked him, what do you remember most? And he said, the fishing and the hunting.
Yes.
If you didn't know Donnie, he loved to fish. He was an outdoorsy person. Riding his bike, fishing, hunting. I think a week before he passed, he was hunting. Got a couple deers. But that was Donnie. He loved being outside. But his brother really misses him right now. So keep him in your prayers. He's really struggling with his, you know, if you have a twin, which not many of us do, but they were super close, super tight. So keep him in your prayers. My brother Aaron, they connected with guns. In case you didn't know, Donnie has a small arsenal at his house. He has a gun everywhere. He's ready for the apocalypse. But Aaron loved that, and that's how they connected. And he just had a connection with everyone in their own special way. Justin and Kyle, I think of people back in Illinois, the connections he had. But for me, my connection was right here in the church. I didn't like the barbecue that much. Actually, I did. I thought I was doing something until I met him and Will. And then I retired from that. I wasn't into guns. He got me a few, but I couldn't even tell you where they're at right now. But my thing was church. And a lot of you know I'm all about the Lord and this church right here. And from day one, from the minute he got here, he was at church. He was at my Bible studies at my house. And that's how I connected with my dad. So I thank God that he did have that fear that you were talking about. It was important for me for him to be here. And not only did he come and just fill the seat, but he felt conviction for his life of sin. He repented. He got right with the Lord. And then he kept coming. And if you guys don't know where he lives about 30 minutes away. And he would come almost every Sunday. And the days that he couldn't come, he would watch online.
Yes.
He loved the Lord.
Yes, he did.
And I had called my mom today and I said, how do you know he was saved? How could you tell the difference? And she gave me a list of 100 things that she saw different. Where he didn't care about life to caring about life. To where he, you know, had a drinking problem where he stopped drinking so much. He was at church every opportunity he could, you know, health withstanding, you know, he was here. His whole life was different. His whole demeanor was different. And I thank God that God did that.
Yes.
And it's nothing that we can do to change our lives, but God has to do it.
That's right.
And I thank him that he did that with Donnie. And the way he set everything up, 70s, when you guys were together?
Yeah. Yes.
70s. Yes. Some of y'all can't count that far back. All the way to 2020. God put all this in motion. He set it all up. For Donnie to be here, to come to this church, to come to the Bible study, to hear about the Lord, to hear the gospel, and to accept Jesus into his heart. So I can't sit up here and cry as much as I want to. I watched that slideshow Lanisa made about 10 times, and I got all my tears out at home. I don't know if I have any more in my tear ducts, but I miss him. It didn't hit me really until today, this afternoon, that he's gone. But I know where he's at.
Yes.
And that's what brings me joy. And I'm at peace with that. As selfish as I would want him here, sitting right here, I'm glad he's where he's at. And he had a chance to receive Jesus into his heart before he passed away. He had a heart attack in his sleep, as Shelly mentioned. And it's just a reminder that we don't know when we're going to take our last breath. He thought he was going to take a nap and get up and have dinner with my mom, and little did he know he was going to go see the Lord instead. That could happen to any of us in here. Doesn't matter how old you are, how young you are. So if Donnie was here and he knew that he was going to pass when he did, I think he would tell you to get right with the Lord. He wouldn't tell you to go live it up. He wouldn't tell you to go on a trip. He would say, get right with the Lord while you can. Because you don't know when you're going to take your last breath. So let's do that. Think about your soul. Think about what's going to happen if you leave out of here and get in a car wreck. Or you have a heart attack. Where are you going to spend eternity? This life is just a blink. But eternity is eternity. It's forever. And Donnie would want you guys to be there with him in heaven. But we know there's only one way to the Father, right? That's through Jesus. So if you're not right with the Lord, I would suggest you do business with him today, because Donnie would want you to my family. And you know, I'm not here to judge you. I'm not here to point fingers, but you know your relationship with the Lord, what it is, what it isn't, what it needs to be. So if you ever want to talk, pray, come see me, come talk to me. I love you guys. Donnie loves you. A lot of you here, we went down to the altar one time, me and Donnie, and we prayed for you guys.
Precious Jesus.
We prayed for you guys. Little y'all may not have known, he may not have ever told you guys, but we prayed for you, that you guys would accept Jesus into your heart, that you guys would see the bigger picture as he saw it, and he was getting ready to take that step. You don't know this, but you were fixing to lose your husband. He was going to start coming on Fridays and Wednesdays. He had made that commitment to me that Sunday before he passed. Pastor prayed with him, and he made that commitment that he was going to go all out for the Lord. God called him home instead. So, Mom, if we want to see him again, we know what we have to do. Renee. Everybody, myself included. So, I think we're going to sing songs now.
Yes.
You guys wouldn't mind standing with us as we sing a couple songs and get ready to close out here with Pastor saying a few words at the end.
I'm not afraid to
Praise you, Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. You may be seated. Well, I sure thank God for tonight. I thank God for this opportunity we have to be here and celebrate Donnie's life. I am so blessed to say that I was his pastor. I so thank God that God brought him into our life and me into his life and the life of this family. And as a pastor, what I'm called to do and what I can't help but do is try to get people ready for heaven. Because it doesn't matter what all I do to comfort people on earth. If they don't make it to heaven, then I failed. And I don't want to fail. Because there's other things you can fail at that don't matter too much. But when you fail to get people to heaven, you failed. The worst possible failure. So I thank God that I was able to minister to Donnie, even to pray with him his last service here. He came and he knelt at the back. We have our altars so that people don't have to get close together. And he was at the back altar. And when I got there, tears were coming down his cheeks. And I prayed with him, not knowing exactly what he was praying about. Then when he finished, I just said, Donnie, I said, where do you stand with the Lord? And he said, I believe that I'm right with God. Amen. He said, but I know I've got to move forward. He said, I know I've got to go forward. I've got to. We know, how many know we have to grow in the Lord? And we have to take those steps. And so as Anthony said, he committed on that day that he was going to go forward and really seek the Lord in every part of his life. And, you know, we have to know the Word of God. Because everything in this world is determined by what God says. And if we don't know the Bible, we don't know what God's saying, and we don't know what we're doing. And we got to line our life up with God's Word. So we praise God. Well, how many people do you think, if there was a spaceship that you could get on to go to heaven, and it didn't cost too much, how many think that, boy, that would be a lot of people would want to go? If all I had to do was raise up some money and get on a rocket, get in some kind of space travel and go to heaven. Well, we know there's a lot of power in rockets, in spaceships, whatever. There's a lot of power there. But that power won't take you to heaven. That fuel and that spaceship won't get you there. But there is a power that will get you there.
Right.
And it's the power of faith.
Amen.
It is the power of belief.
Yes.
Power of faith. Can I have the first slide? Please. Everything is possible to the one who believes.
Amen.
The power of faith can get us to heaven. The power of praise God. Everything is possible for the one who believes. Next slide. All things are possible with God. So it has to be faith in God, doesn't it? People have faith to build the spaceships and all the things that are built in the world. They have to have faith, but that faith won't get you to heaven. The faith has to be in God. Amen. So the next slide explains it. For God so loved the world, who is the world, all people, that he gave his one and only Son to die on the cross, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, go to hell, but have eternal life, go to heaven. So the word believing is the pivotal word there, isn't it? A way has been made to go to heaven. But we have to believe.
Amen.
Amen. Whoever believes in him. So the faith has to be focused on and in Jesus Christ. I love where it says, whoever believes in him. Praise God. It means they put their faith in him. Trusting in him. Amen.
Yeah.
Next slide, please. So we need to understand That we have to believe that Jesus is the only way. If we think Jesus is a way, we can't be saved. We can't think that we can be saved by Jesus or by Buddha or by Muhammad or by Confucius, some other prophet. Jesus said, I am the way.
Amen.
And the truth and the life.
Amen.
No one comes to the Father except through me. So we understand that this powerful force that can get us to heaven, this faith has to be anchored in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We have to make Him our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Next slide, please. Thank you. And so, because we were all born in sin, every one of us was born a sinner.
Yeah, that's true.
And so, without help, we can't get to heaven.
Right.
All have sinned and fall short of the glory. There's not one person that measures up in themselves to what God requires.
Right.
No matter how many good works you do, have done, it's not enough. Because works is not the way to heaven. It's faith. It's believing. Praise God.
Amen.
And everybody can believe. Isn't that great?
Yes.
Not everybody can afford a spaceship trip to heaven.
Right.
But we can all afford to believe.
Yes.
Because we've been given the ability to believe. So all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And all are justified freely by His grace. Through the redemption that came by Christ Jesus. So what that's telling us is that Jesus has made the way for us.
That's right.
It's not adding another good work to what you have done. Justified freely by His grace means it's free.
Right.
That salvation is free.
Right.
It's a gift of God. Justified means made right with God. When we are in sin, we are God's enemy. We set ourselves up as God's enemy. But when He justifies us, He wipes the slate clean. And there is nothing held against us. We are no longer God's enemy. Because we've accepted His offer of redemption that came by Christ Jesus. He was the substitute for our need.
Amen.
You get on a cross and die, it won't save you. But He took our place. He died in our place. He died in our place. Praise God. So through His death, redemption is available, salvation. Redemption is redeeming us back from the fall. Redeeming us back from a life of sin. Next slide, please. God presented Christ as a sacrifice of atonement through the shedding of His blood to be received by faith. If you can ever come to the place of believing in Him, receiving the gift of salvation by faith, that is power.
Amen.
That is what we're looking for, isn't it?
Right.
Praise God. So the next one, please. Thank you. Jesus said, if we do not believe that He is who He says He is, we will die in our sins. If we do not believe that He's the answer to our sin problem, I need an amen.
Amen.
If we do not believe that He's the answer to our sin problem, we'll die in our sins. And there's no hope for us. But hell.
Yeah.
So we must believe that He is the way.
Amen.
That He is the truth. He is the life. He is the answer to our sin problem.
Right.
Complete answer.
Yeah.
Not partial answer. Total answer. My answer is in Jesus.
Amen.
He is my hope. He is my help.
Right.
Yes.
He is my salvation. Next slide, please. So Jesus said, everyone who sins is a slave to sin. So what He's saying is that when we sin, it's because we're a sinner. Because we have a sin nature. And do you understand that sinners can't help but sin? So everyone who sins is a slave to sin because they're a slave to their sin nature. Their sin nature is dictating what they're going to do. We were born with a sin nature. Now these people he's talking to believe they're going to heaven. But he tells them, if you're a slave, if you're caught in sin, you have no permanent place in God's family. If you are living in sin, if you are sinning, you have no place in God's family.
Right.
Now, look at it. A slave has, everyone who sins is a slave to sin. Now, a slave has no permanent place in the family. Now, you don't hear this in most places, guys. Most places you go to church, you don't hear this.
Right.
But I'm giving it to you, and it will help you get to heaven. If you believe the word and not believe what's the going theology.
Right.
A person that's living in sin has no place in God's family. But a child of God belongs to it forever.
Right.
We have become a child of God through faith in Jesus Christ. But look what he says. Jesus is a son forever.
Amen.
And he can set you free.
That's right, amen.
The Jews could not be set free by the law. There was nothing they could do to be set free from sin. Only the Son of God can set us free from sin.
Amen.
Faith in him sets us free from sin. Please help me. Faith in Jesus Christ. If we believe it, amen? If you believe some lie, you can't be set free. But if you can believe the truth, he says, if you know the truth, where is it there? It's not there. What happened? That must be a different version. So if the Son sets you free, you will be. Oh, I love the version that says, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free.
Amen.
Praise God.
Yes.
The truth that Jesus sets us free.
Amen.
Praise God. Next slide.
Right.
Praise God. Now, give me a blank, can you, for a second? So how does he set us free? We're going to look at it in a minute, but I want to say something before. First thing he does, when you come to him for salvation, he forgives all your sins.
Right.
Now, as I was getting ready today, the Lord spoke to me, and I said, I was asking the Lord, why is it that we have to repent? We have to repent because if we don't really want to come out of that life, he can't really forgive us.
Right.
If we don't really want a new life, if we just want the momentary guilt relieved off of our shoulders, then he can't forgive us. But if we really want a change, amen?
Right.
Repentance means I've made up my mind.
Yeah.
I've changed my mind.
All right. Yes.
I don't want just a quick fix.
Right.
I want to be a new person.
Right.
And you know, when you get low enough, you'll reach up to him.
Right. Amen.
If you get a chance before you go out of this world.
Right.
So don't wait till you get so low that you can't even pray.
Right. Since, amen.
But this is the miracle I want to, next verse. There is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, who are in a saving relationship with Jesus Christ, will not die and go to hell.
Right.
There is now no hell for those who are in Christ Jesus.
Right.
I got one amen, two.
Amen.
There is now no hell for those who are in Christ Jesus, because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit who gives life has set you free from the law of sin and death. Now, I have to explain this. When there's no way for a sinner to get to heaven. Now, let me ask you, is there any way for a person to get into the air and fly? Is there any way for us to rise up from the ground and fly? We can't do that because of the law of gravity. There's a law at work, right? When we are in sin, a law is at work. What is a law? A law is a settled power over us. It's unchangeable. Is the law of sin and death up there? Okay? The law of sin and death is a law that's in operation. And according to this law, that if we study the Bible, we'll understand it better. But the law of sin and death is that we sin and we die because of our sin. But we don't just die, we go to hell. So there's a law in place that sinners cannot go to heaven according to this law. How many can stay with me just a minute to finish, okay? So that kind of shuts the door on heaven for us. Except for the fact, through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit who gives life has set you free from the law of sin and death.
Amen.
So what the law of the Spirit of life does is cancel out the law of sin and death.
Right.
It supersedes the law of sin and death.
Right.
How does that happen? How can we be under a law of the Spirit of life and set free from the law of sin and death? By faith. What did I say the greatest power is? Faith in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Faith in Jesus Christ and Him crucified.
Right.
Faith in the truth that our salvation comes through His death. You can come to Christ and not totally understand that, but that's what's happening. Your faith in Him is your faith in His death. What He did on the cross for you sets you free. If you can believe in Him and what He did. Now, there's no condemnation for those who are in Christ. Now you say, well, I can come to Christ and I can be forgiven of all my sin, but I'll go back and sin again. I'll go back into sin. And He's saying, this new law of the Spirit that gives life cancels out that other law. Amen. How many say I'm a little bit confused? How many can stay with me 5 more minutes?
Amen.
Through Christ Jesus, faith in Him, the law of the Spirit who gives life has set you free from the law of sin and death. Go ahead into the next verse. I'm going to, 2 more verses. He said, for what the law was powerless to do, this is God's law in the Bible. You cannot, by reading God's law, you cannot be saved. By just trying to keep God's law. Thou shalt not this, thou shalt not that. How many know there's 10 commandments?
Yeah.
Thou shalt not lie. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not curse the name of the Lord. All the things we feel guilty for when we do them. That law is powerless to save us. All God's law can do is show us that we're sinners.
Right.
True. Right?
Yeah.
Because we don't have the power to obey it. How many know? You've wanted to do right, but you don't have the power. You want to stop doing something, but you can't stop. Right?
Yeah.
You know, if you could do what's right, you wouldn't need God.
Right.
If you could really do what's right, you wouldn't need a Savior.
Yeah. Yeah.
You could save yourself. But not one of us can save ourselves. That law is powerless. God's word is powerless. God's law of what to do and what not to do. But God sent His Son in the likeness of... He came like us. He became just like us. Except without sin. And He was the perfect sacrifice for us. He became us offering. He took our place. Next slide. He took our place. And so He condemns sin in the flesh. I don't like this version. But what it means is God dealt with our problem.
Yeah.
He didn't condemn us, he condemned the sin. He condemned the sin nature that we're born with. He dealt with our sin nature on the cross. Praise God. In order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fully met in us who do not live according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. What that is saying is that through the law of the Spirit of life, He comes to live in us.
Amen.
So that we can live a new life.
Amen.
It's a law, but it's a life.
Amen.
It's a new law that cancels out the old law.
Right.
I can't help but sin, and because I'm sinning, I'm going to go to hell. I understand that's a law. It's a settled thing. And we can't change that.
Right.
But we have a greater law that's been given.
Amen.
The law of the Spirit of life.
Amen.
That cancels out the law of sin and death. Praise God.
Amen.
You know, for centuries, man wanted to fly. I say man, meaning, how far back do you think people wanted to fly? They saw birds flying. And people, I would say as long as the world's been here, people tried to find a way to fly. And how many have heard of the Wright brothers? That, how long ago was that? 100 years? 150 years ago. The Wright brothers found out that there was a law that canceled out the law of gravity. Wasn't that amazing?
Right.
And planes are going all over the world.
Amen.
Because they found out there was another law. Amen.
Yeah.
That canceled out the law of gravity. They found out that if the planes were built with this aerodynamic design, how somehow they figured out these little bitty planes that they started building, they had to have this certain design. How many understand that a little bit? That the plane has to be, the craft, aircraft has to be built according to a certain design. And of course it has to have fuel, right? And it has to reach 200 miles per hour. And when it reaches 200 miles per hour, a new law takes effect. And it's called the law of lift.
Amen.
It's called the law of lift.
Amen.
And the plane is going to lift up from the ground at that. Isn't that
Amen.
Wonderful for us to try to understand? A spiritual law is like a natural law, isn't it?
Right.
Praise God. The law of sin and death will never get to heaven, right? But the law of the Spirit of life. Well, Jesus not only forgives our sin, but He comes to live in us to give us the power. Come on, I need some help.
Amen.
To give us the power to live a whole new life.
Right.
Praise God. And the law of Spirit of life cancels out the law of sin and death. Who would like to say praise God?
Amen.
We just sang praise. This is good news.
Amen.
See, the gospel is good news.
Amen.
And if you would really think about it, you would get real excited.
Amen. Amen.
Right? Amen?
Amen.
Say, I don't have to go to hell.
I don't have to go to hell.
Because of what Jesus has done.
Because of what Jesus
for me.
Did.
For me.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God. And so He says, well, does this mean that we don't have to obey God's laws? No, look at it. He dealt with our sin nature. That first means He condemned sin and the sin in the flesh. By coming to live in us, He gives us power over our sin nature. He renders our sin nature powerless when He comes to live in us. Amen.
Amen. Yes, amen.
In order that the righteous requirement, God's not going to quit on His laws. His laws have to be kept, don't they?
Amen.
How are they met? How in the world can I obey God? Because I don't live according to the sin nature anymore, but according to the Spirit. Amen?
Right.
There's a condition. There's a condition. Amen? The condition, we have to live according to the Spirit. As many as are led by the Spirit are the children of God. As many as are led. Mr. Donnie, 2 weeks ago on Sunday, the Spirit was leading him to go forward and really get to know God and really deal with the Word. And he said yes. He was saying yes to the Spirit. That's the condition. That's the condition. And so an airplane will stay in the air as long as it's over 200 miles per hour and there's plenty of fuel.
Yeah.
Do you know it's really hard to get that plane out of the air? People think it's not very safe up there, but it's really safe as long as it has fuel,
right?
And maintains that. And so in order for the plane to come down, it has to break those laws of new laws. We have to, I don't even know how they bring a plane down. What am I talking about?
Yeah.
I don't know. But pretty soon, gravity,
yeah.
You know, the law of gravity.
Yeah.
Well, guys, we don't ever have to go back to the law of gravity in our hearts. We don't ever have to go back to sin.
Right.
Can anybody say amen to that?
Yeah.
I don't have to go back.
Right.
Praise God. Amen. Praise God. You know, we see people delivered here. We see people's lives radically changed.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Would you lift your hand up, Kevin? A few months ago, we went passing out. In fact, Anthony did it. Passed out a flyer. And he got a flyer. He was drinking, alcoholic. Went into a alcoholic, almost coma, and through that he cried out to the Lord.
Amen.
He put his faith in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And he delivered him.
Yes.
And brought him brought him out of that life into a whole new life with Christ. And I'm just saying one example of what God does.
Amen.
Every single person's life changes. What you couldn't stop doing before, you can stop.
Amen.
You don't even want to do it anymore.
Amen.
Isn't that amazing? He takes away the old and gives us the new.
Amen.
Everyone that's in Christ Jesus is a brand new creature. The old is gone and the new has come.
Amen.
Praise God. Well, on Wednesday of this week, my husband came in and he told me that this man named Hal Perkins, who I went to high school with and graduated with, my husband came and said, he's just about to die with COVID. He said, they don't give him any hope or chance or whatever. And I listened to that. I heard a couple times he was pretty sick, and then we get the word that he's dying. And I said, these words came out of my mouth. He's not going to die. He's going to live.
Amen.
And about that time, up in Kansas, something happened. And I'm not saying I was the only one. But I'm telling you that faith rose up in me.
Amen.
And I said, no, he will not die. He is going to live. I came to church that night and I said the same thing. Wednesday night, I said, he's very sick, but he's not going to die. He's going to live.
Amen.
All the doctors said he was going to die.
Right.
That afternoon, about the time that I told Charles he's not going to die, he turned around. And his wife, they took him out of ICU, and his wife spent the evening, and they told him that his lungs were gone. The next day, they checked his lungs, and he was healed. He was still in the hospital, but he told his wife to put on Facebook, God has worked a miracle in my life.
Yes, he has.
God has worked. 75 years old. 75-year-old man. He's not young. I'm not young. We're old. But God can do anything.
Yes, he can.
So I'm trying to tell you there's power in faith.
Yes.
And faith in Jesus Christ can do anything. We used to sing a song, faith in God can move a mighty mountain.
Yes.
Faith can calm the troubled sea. Faith can make the desert like a fountain. Death can bring the victory. I mean, faith can bring the victory. Whoa! Praise God. You know what? I'm so glad I got to share tonight. Because I want you in heaven.
Amen.
More than I want anything in this world.
That's right.
I don't want anything in this world.
Right, no.
There's nothing I want.
Right.
I want you in heaven. I want you in heaven. Whether you live a long time or whether you don't, it doesn't matter. Help me understand that.
Right.
If you're right with God, it doesn't matter. Because it's better to be with Him than be here.
Yeah.
So the length of our life doesn't matter.
Right.
Really. It's the quality. It's whether we are in Christ.
Amen.
Can we go back to the second slide? The second slide. Thank you. From the front. I just want to quote that one more time. I want us to quote it together. The second one from the front. John 3:16. Please. Yes. All the way back. Thank you. Okay. See? Wow. For God so loved all the people of the world that He gave His Son to die. His one and only Son to die on the cross. That whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Lord Jesus, I am so thankful that Your word never changes.
That's right.
And that You never change.
That's right.
You are the same. Yesterday, today, forever. Your word is infallible.
Yes, it is.
And it's unchangeable. And You said, whoever believes in You, and we know the word believes there is continuous belief,
amen,
continuous walking with You, shall not go to hell.
That's right.
But shall have everlasting life, shall live forever and ever. And I so thank You.
Yes.
I so thank You for this night. I so thank You for bringing us together. We may never be like this again. So special. We're so thankful. We're so thankful that You strengthened Alina during this time. And Anthony and the families. Thank You for all that You're doing to help the family through. To help our church through this loss. But as Anthony said, Donnie would want everyone in the family to come to Christ, to give their lives to Jesus Christ, to become a new person in Jesus Christ. Not just with your heads bowed and your eyes closed. I just want to ask, is there anyone that say, Pastor Barbara, that's what I want. Just raise your hand where you're at. Nobody looking around. That's what I want. Just raise your hand where you are. Anyone here? And I'm not saying I'll have you come forward tonight, but I just want you to want to know if you want me to pray for you. Anyone? Pastor Barbara, that's what I want. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Anyone else? Anyone else? Lord Jesus, we thank You. We thank You that Your truth has been shown tonight. Your gospel is the most powerful truth on the face of the earth. Your gospel will change our lives. We are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it's the power of salvation for everyone who believes. For in the gospel, a righteousness is revealed, a righteousness that is by faith from first to last. As it is written, the just shall live by faith. Thank You for the powerful power of faith. Faith in Jesus Christ. No power on the earth is stronger, is greater than the faith anchored in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As our Lord and Savior. We thank You and praise You in Your name. Amen. Now, we are going to close with a song. We don't have it up there because I didn't tell you. You have to come over here. Okay.
Amen.
And that's what we want for everyone.
Yes.
And those that say they are believers, We have to remain true to Jesus.
Amen, amen,
we have to continue to walk with Him. If we are not believers, we can be a believer.
Yes.
If we'll just believe.
Amen.
Truly believe.
Amen.
Truly put our faith in Jesus Christ. Oh God, we just pray that you will go with the family as they go. You will
surround them, Lord.
Go with each person. And thank you, Lord, that in the midst of this pandemic, we were able to come.
Thank you, Jesus.
And just praise you.
To you be the glory, God.
And bring glory
for this
and honor to you.